Hello, it's George Lees again. That's George Lees pretending to be a waiter in the Mafiosa. Yep, with the tongue in the cheek. Tongue in cheek is applicable to everything about that story. Okay? Yeah, every time that erupts, it tells the human race that there is something terribly, terribly wrong with the way that the world is being run. Okay? Same with the seismic activities. They can literally get away with murder. Church of Rome, all of the denominations are fake ups. All of them are entirely for profit. And now you're seeing the victims are coming, not only from the innocent side, but the side that pretend that the world is a fearful place. Yeah? All of them now are in the shallow graves that they have created using profiteers like him and methods like him. Okay? And that is the Waterloo nominees joke about the massive Ponzi schemes of the Piso family relatives who are still trading in Britain. Okay? That's the Waterloo joke. Okay? I'm going to play you now how tragic all of this is. I'm going to quickly show you what the story is today, because I'm bringing together the political influences, the military influences, and the criminal techniques and the laundering techniques that allow everyone to capture the minds with false religion, to make them fearful with media stories and movies, and to kill the innocents everywhere when the opportunity arises. And that includes in the Great Wars, the killing of 8 million Christian denominations, or followers, yeah, by the others who survived the Great Conflict. All of the 30 years war was for Christianity and bigotry. Okay, and you've got massive now energy companies, massive conglomerations of business frauds, yeah, that are of the same magnitude of the stealing of every central bank on our globe. So I'm going to play you this music first today. It is absolutely tragic that every one of our patriots, yeah, and I've got Max Bygraves highlighted, Gavin Hastings missing the kick in front of the posts, and the religious frauds all over the world, yeah, on my website now. And the videos are now, Google will not let me post images directly to my website, because if I were to be able to do that, every image I post would have a title, and it would mean that every image I post and every topic I cover in my videos would come up on Google Images, and that would be a tragedy for the traitors that run the world. The papacy, the Rothschilds, all of the political puppets that do pretend that they understand the weight of their commitment to their country, but they sell it entirely. And the last one is the Braveheart myth, because Braveheart's missus, yeah, is called Mirren. And the woman that got her throat cut was Mirren. Yeah, she got her throat cut because she tried to defend herself against rape and the prima nocte bedroom activities that the invading English armies and their leaders demanded of the local people. Yeah, so not only are you selling your country when you kowtow to these people, yeah, we've lost all of our capacity to fund our nations and to say that we are the owners of them. Okay? And so the St. Mirren joke, and the Mirren joke is that the abbey in Paisley, which is the Piso family joke, that's Paisley, yeah, it is named St. Mirren's Abbey. Yeah? That's the death of the legends that fought for Scotland and to free them. And I was going to show you a picture of the Tartan army, but when you think back to all of the things that occur there, and the people that are prepared to go around the world ballistically supporting Scotland, when all of these political manipulations have stripped them of everything that their country could possess for free. Okay, it's really sad, and this music has been ringing in my head because our countries all have been sold. Every one of the countries across the globe now is now owned by the private interests that were the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, the big banking groups, and the monarchies, like the Royal Dutch Shell joke.
Thank you.
So there's the victim. She got married in secret so that she could not be raped by him and the effete English people, yeah, that send all of the soldiers to their death, yeah, and they are in charge of Scotland for century after century. Okay, the church in Britain emanates from this joke, the Cluny Abbeys that we told you about yesterday, and there's handsome George Clooney, yeah, and there is where Christianity ended up in sectarian Glasgow in the Paisley region, and they launch him into Ireland and all of these criminals, and the violence goes on for decades and decades, and there never was a Jesus Christ, and all of the elites that are in all of these scams understand it, which is why Hollywood make the hilarious movies, and the saltire is a joke about the coat of arms of the Cluny Abbey in France, where all the Freemasons come up here. They come across to the Hastings coast, where the supermarket is still called the Priory supermarket in Hastings, and it sweeps onto the French rugby jersey, and the Freemasons follow the whole of the global story for a laugh, and no one now is able to fund any of their democracies, and the IMF and its subsidiaries are run from France because they are the people that are Strauss-Kahn and Miss Lagarde, massive financial criminals. The Cahills, the joke about Calvary Hill, are killers in intel. There's not a picture of him because there are 50 or 60 of the different deviant bastards running around stealing from our country. Many of them work for intel, yeah, in the heart of London. Yeah, and that's where the Irish terror is run by the Prime Ministers, the Lib Dems, and the Irish Quislings that sell their country, like the Scottish Quislings that sell their country. And then when they come together in massive political meetings, it costs millions of pounds. Yeah, and then they pretend that the poor people have to get poorer. Yeah, because there's no money left in the public fucking purse. Right then. So, do you remember that Max Bygraves used to sing on the Eric and Ernie show that the Queen that visited Ireland for the first time in her lifetime when she was aged nearly 80, yeah, and was prepared to shake her hands with those dangerous frauds that are frauds for decades like her? Yeah, her dad is Winston Churchill for a laugh. And so Max Bygraves is joked at, yeah, because he sings about fucking the place in Avignon, right at the bottom of this criminal trail of Christianity, which is just to the south of the Abbey at Cluny, one of the richest institutions on the globe. I'm going to tell you about that in the timeline later on, and the evolution of this Christian fraud all over the world. So Avignon is where the Pope lives when we have three popes at the same time for profit, and so they can launch the inquisitions against the innocent clerics and the innocent people of the world and get rid of their bloodlines almost entirely.
Her proudest in Avignon, her mama weeps loud. singing in Avignon. Lovers' lips are clinging in Avignon. A true love story in all its glory is theirs.
Go behind again. Hastings from under 20 metres. And he's missed it, would you believe it? He sliced the kick.
I would believe it. He's also the man who sold London Scottish, yeah, into the debt pool and eventually crashed it in favour of Bristol Rugby Club so they could have their elite place in the elite pecking order, because they're a slaving centre and they're a money laundering centre for the elites. And it's getting really gusty outside again. Yeah, this is Free Scotland. Within 1 year of the referendum, they're pretending that they're going to have another one, because there is no politics now. There is no governance for our nations. All they do is cover up the ancient sins of all of the institutions that now run our world. That's centuries old and millennia old sins, as those images showed you. Okay, right then. What else can I play you? So do you get the Mirren joke? It's absolutely tragic. Yeah, she's about to have her throat cut for defending her capacity to be with her husband. Yeah, and she gets raped by the trivial people. Yeah. And just before I left New Zealand, the rapist was in the situation where I met him when I was returning from a conference. The whole of this story, I don't know whether the body doubles are just spookish acts of God, or whether or not they are still trying to pretend that this is not a premeditated plot, yet to take all of the wealth from all of the world's people and to put it into their havens. We mentioned the Isle of Man yesterday, and the tax havens are right next door to the Republic of Ulster. Yeah, and right next door to the massacre scene for the killing of all of those honest policemen and servicemen, yeah, who have to go into these crime scenes. They get hated by the locals because they're sent there by the profiteers. Yeah, all of the profiteers, right the way up to the top of world ownership. Okay, so just a little snippet from Braveheart to show you that the patriotism is a thing of the past. Yeah, I don't know whether or not William Wallace did exist. The cloud patterns last night were magnificent as I watched the movie again. It's all about treason. There is no genuine leadership, with the possible exception of his character. But because the battle was near the Torah Wood, which is the Jewish clerical document, I very much doubt that very much of that history is accurate. And he's commemorated right next to David Murray's golf course and the Freemasonic hub that is the place called Dryborough. Yeah, where the heart of William Wallace, the traitor in the movie, is portrayed as being buried. And he's the typical Scottish plotter that works against his country. Yeah, and the Bruces are still massive directorial fraudsters in the City of London and all over the world, because this is now globalised. There is no escape from it. Until I come along. We'll be right back. when this one left to become an educated Latin, Italian, French speaker, you know that that is part of the joke, because to be in the inner circle, you need to be gifted linguistically, which is why he forms a natural bond with the French princess, because they are both in the super elites. Yeah, and that is the joke. It's the inner circle that is the Christianity fraud, and because Hastings is on the south coast, that is associated with the tyrannical launch of the Rothschild's arrows into King Harry's eyes. Yeah, and all of it is a massive joke, okay? And the saltire joke is typical of everything that the Glaswegians and the Scottish patriots out of the speculative society in Edinburgh do to our country, even today, though there is no law enforcement. Yet they get away with everything in the financial services crimes, covered up entirely by the Scotsman that was also edited by Hastings. I think Max Hastings. Yeah, the Max name is a sad joke about Maximus and the slaves, because the slaves are on the crucifixes. Yeah, when Christianity is launched, yeah, it is a tool to cull everybody and to create violence everywhere on the world. And his name is a joke about the place where the Holy Roman Emperor lived, with the word casino in it, which is why he makes the casino movie. Now, we did all of that yesterday, so today I'm going to take you back to the list of priories and give everybody regionally some insight into where the Piso fraud spread to once they'd gotten to Lewes and Hastings across the Channel coast and out of Cluny, where the massive abbey was and all of the treasures are now in the Louvre or the Paris Museum. Yeah, and everybody just thinks this is the only way that life can be. Yeah, for centuries in all of the wars. And do you get it? That's world leaders. Yet gifted positions as head of NATO, head of the UN, allowed to pick their speakers, allowed to stand on the beach and say that there's a nuclear threat, yet when they're covering the sins of the Balfours and the Robert Louis Balfour Stevensons on the Lothian coast, where their constituency is, and Police Scotland pretend that they are detecting murderers of little boys, yeah, the McHale joke, all of it is wrapped up into the same tragic saga. Yeah, they are totally deviant, every one of our world leaders. And only because Cameron's been already subjected to an act of God with his children is he paying even token attention. He's again demonising Islam, and we are again on the verge of World War III. Yeah, which is actually World War 8 or 9 because of all of the sectarian conflicts that they overlook, which sweep over the whole of Europe initially, and now that Christianity is globalised, we kill everybody everywhere to keep the power base, and it's done by the people that work for the governments that are now the mafias. Okay, so you've got the broader picture now. I'm going to take you down into the smaller elements of this, okay, and I'm going to take you through every little village in England that is the victim of this crime, because the worshippers are not in the inner circle and they give up their faith and their cash to the corrupted cause. So we got very slightly down this thing, and we mentioned Bath, and we mentioned the Forest of Dean because of the BBC's jokes there, yeah, and I forgot to mention that the Rastafarian movement was very prevalent in Bath. Yeah, that's the Lion of Judah, Ethiopia, Nile jokes. Yeah, the people with the long curly hairs, and what they are there to do is to cover up the Christianity issues and all of the genocides that occurred in the Nile Valley and in Ethiopia committed by the Italians. Okay, right then, so every one of them is a joke about the fictitious people that are now the mother of God. Yeah, That's the non-existent human that is now declared to be the mother of God. Okay, Amesbury, Wiltshire, yeah, near Stonehenge, been there, done it. Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah, how they're able to get away with it without the ordinary people detecting it. The friars again. Yeah, these are all priories, which was the top of the power base when the Cluny Abbey in France was hosting the papacy at one time, and that then became the Holy Roman Emperor, and it became the man Charlemagne, and his son was in yesterday's story. Okay, so Bath Abbey, Buch if Derbyshire, and they've got, so they're, some of them are Austin friars, some of them are the Benedictine fraud that was the same as the Cluny Abbey. Okay, so the Benedictine thing, you can see why they pick the names of the popes, and the popes are allowed to change their names for shame. Okay, so this, the Derbyshire Buch if place was Premonstration. Premonstration. The West Tower is all that survives of the former abbey. Okay? Was, and which, to which a private chapel was added in the 17th century. Yet all of the land grabs in the Braveheart story are explained all the way down into the south of England. Yet the Scottish estates that are run by Dukes of Buccleuch and the Scott family, who worship at the same church as me, some of them cannot get down the aisle to take communion. And I know why that is. And so do they now. And they fear that there is a God in the heavens, and that after all these years, they're beginning to limp. And some of them die horrible deaths in accidents that are not accidents at all. Here's Bewley Abbey again in Hampshire. This is a Cistercian monastery, the Church of the Blessed Virgin and Child. Binham Priory, Benedictine again, St. Mary's. Birkenhead Priory in Liverpool met charming people at the dog show from Liverpool. Yeah, looked a little bit like the icons that used to be in the pop singing sector, but far too young. Okay, Benedictine. Birkenhead, Merseyside, right next door to the golf course and the race course and all of the usual suspects for world ownership, the racing hippos. Bishopsgate, St. Helens, rugby league country. Okay, St. Helens in the Aegean, yeah, launched the ships of the earliest civilization with many, many gods in the skies that they worshipped. Yeah, St. Helens Church has been developed from a priory, Benedictine, with nuns in it. Yeah, a joke about the naming of Jesus, and it's in also the Arthurian legends. Blackmore Priory, the Essex girls, don't know whether or not they've got nuns. The Essex girls have a bad reputation, but Christianity will have it really soon. That's Augustinian. Yeah, that's the Nerva Augustine movement. Yeah, and the Nerva Antonine movement that also moved into Scotland as a different subsidiary of the Mafia and built the wall with the Roman armies behind it. This is Northumbria, Blanchland Abbey. We used to go there with the kids and all of what I thought were our innocent neighbours. Members of the Rotary Club, none of them will speak to me now. Yeah, all of them pretended to be my friends, and they pretended to be sad when we left Northumberland. The only reason we left were my children were inspired by the Lord of the Rings movie, which is a joke about the inner circle, and every one of the characters is a financial criminal or genocidal leader in the course of this story that I'm telling you now. Okay, also St. Mary's, they're very unimaginative. Blythe, yeah, right next door to where we used to go for our holidays, yeah, on very near the beaches where the El Cid film was made, and because they ran out of fake weapons, Yeah, they used golf clubs in the El Cid battle scenes against the threat from the Moors from North Africa, where Michael Moore has his business registers with the Bush family and the Scottish Chambers of Commerce, and they also run the Borders College out of Dubai. So that's a Benedictine one in Blyth, Bolton Abbey. Yet the banking crimes, yet the people that have said to me that I need to be more professional in the fishing world, they can no longer afford to go to fishing trips because the cost of the bus is £500 a day. And that man sadly died, and his wife is on the elders team at the Church of Scotland, and they ask for her advice all of the time. The Bolton family are massive banking dynasties and massive financial criminals. They were featured in the Mary Poppins movie, and I taught the man how to fish. I literally took him to the riverside and taught him how to fish. Right then, Bourne Abbey, Lincolnshire, Augustinian, like the Bolton Priory in North Yorkshire. Bygraves Priory, Benedictine, I'm not sure, West Sussex. Oh, that's where the bint comes from, that has 150 husbands or so in Saudi Arabia, interlocked, I believe, to Princess Anne, who runs the Scottish rugby treason and asset strips the whole of it. My dad still does not understand that the clubs no longer have money to take the second team to distant places in our own country. The national team gets on junkets, and he's telling me that they're doing altitude training in preparation for the next World Cup. Scotland win nothing now but the wooden spoon, and it's all that they deserve. And they've got the man playing in the team who they pretend will not play in a Sunday, because they're covering up everything that I say in the local outlets. That's the drinking outlets where the Masons keep their friends but are prepared to desert their own children into the toxic debt pool. Bredon on the Hill, Leicestershire, okay, Church of Mary's again, also Augustinian. Bridlington, East Yorkshire, Augustinian. Brinkburn Priory, Northumberland again. This is the Northern Kingdom, yeah, that our man, the governor for Iraq, Rory Stewart, understands and is a historian for, even although his pockets are lined by Middle Eastern wealth that belonged to Tony Blair's regime. Bristol St. James's Priory, this is the money laundering sector. Yet the woman with the pink toenails that I told you about yesterday, and the massive abbeys that they have in that region. Okay, Benedictine, the godfathers, as it were, yeah, from the CLUNY region. Bromfield Priory, Benedictine, Shropshire, that is, not sure where that is. Bungay, Suffolk. Carisbrook, oh, a notorious crime scene in Ireland, I think. And it's the Isle of Wight, yeah, where Queen Victoria had her only legitimate child and then became a bigamous marriage partner of Prince Albert the Poof. Look up Prince Albert's chain on Wikipedia and it will bring tears to your eyes, and it would have been censored by Mrs. Whitehouse, yeah, when Britain was carefully covering up these massive moral sins and the genocides that ensue. That one's got a chimney on it, as if it might be associated with a death camp or the fire pan joke for them. Cannons Ashby Priory, Northamptonshire, where Princess Diana Spencer Churchill's family kept the elite libraries, like the Roxburgh Book Club, yeah, and the Del Boy Books, Boy Del Books. Yeah, it's all a massive joke. St. Mary's Church, they have no imagination once the citizens swallow the story. Cartmel Priory, Cumbria, where blind Prince George the only legitimate father of Queen Victoria's children came from Chetwode, Buckinghamshire, immune from bombing in World War II, Augustinian. Chirbury Priory, Shropshire, don't know anything about that, named after the Jewish angel. And Augustinian. Christchurch Priory, that's the Dorset one that we briefly focused on, and it's a big one. Yeah, this is not the Christchurch linkage to the English city in New Zealand where they had the massive earthquake because John Key's a millionaire in the hedge fund sector and that's his local town. They call it the English city, and this is the launch in Clerkenwell, the next one is, in London, of the Knights Hospitaliere movement. Yet takes you into Switzerland and the massive cabal of secret societies and banking operations that steal from the world in peacetime and in wartime. Coggeshall Abbey, Essex. Cistercian, oh, there's a new one. Oh, the Knights Hospitalier is as big as the Benedictines and the Augustine movement. Can you see, yeah, how the financial criminals are hiding behind the cross with no Jesus Christ to pin on these crimes because they made him up in the Piso family, which is in the word priories in the plural, Cranborough, Dorset, Benedictine, St Mary's, Croyland Abbey, Lincolnshire, the Flatlands, massive estates for the Quisling Scots dictators and the plotters that sell their country all the time. Which is why I played that emotive music to try and give them a conscience. Dale Abbey, Derbyshire again. Massive links. Premonstratensian. That's a very difficult one for an honest and ordinary man to say. Also runs the infirmary chapel. Can you see why the medic's oath is tied into the snake story all the time? Davington Priory, Kent. Yeah, that is where Hastings is, I think. Or it might be East or West Sussex. Yeah, that's the crime scene for King Harold and the launch of the French armies who swept up to Durham by 1070. And the massive buildings that they erected there in the English city of Durham are still intact after thousands of years. The Scots people had theirs taken down by Henry VIII, who made himself a god and got rid of the papal influence and all of his wife's heads. Deeping St James's Priory, Lincolnshire, the Flatlands again. Deerhurst Priory, Gloucestershire, near Bristol, and the slaving centre, St Mary's again. Dorchester Abbey, Thames, Oxfordshire, immune from bombing, beautiful and still totally intact despite several world wars and global and European conflicts and great schisms. Dore Abbey, Herefordshire, Hereford the Wake. Don't really understand those jokes. There will be fraud behind them or the selling of your local region. Cistercian in that case. Dunstable Priory, Bedfordshire, immune from bombing, heart of the free French Empire that de Gaulle lived in, yeah, and lived it up. And when the returning people came, even if they were double agents in intel, they ended up dead underneath the building. Okay, Dunstan Priory, Somerset, yeah, were the straws in the mouth of the two Ronnies when they make the sick jokes. St George's this time, non-existent saint who tackled the dragon that is wrapped around the snake and becomes the penis in all of the jokes about the pinnacle and the profiteers sitting on top of them because there is no heaven to go to. And they have not got an air balloon when they're dead. Eddington Priory near Wiltshire, not Eddington, Wiltshire, the Church of St Mary again and St Catherine. And All Saints, all of them faked up, all of them in ancient history revered and loved, And we've now got a Saint MacKillop and a Saint, what's the name of the family that is up in the royal family's region and are the farmer profiteers? I keep forgetting their name. They were sainted very recently. I got a call from the RBS this morning. Yeah, when I was right in the middle of preparing this data. And the RBS, yeah, were run out of Winston Churchill's place, yeah, that is right next door to Eyemouth. And the gas and electricity collector came from Eyemouth today. Yeah, so he now understands all about the frauds. Yeah, and I've got the details of the new company that sells the capacity to read our meters. Yeah, it's not any of the hundreds of fraudulent subsidiaries the John Major runs. It is now a company called Lowry Beck. I'm going to have a little look for them later on today. Yeah, that's the energy scams that steal from every country in Europe, and they're still selling the same energy that we had in Scotland and all of the outlets that were there in the 1960s when they killed Kennedy, and they used the broom, which is now the bedroom tax at his funeral, yeah, as a joke about the might of the English-speaking world. Okay, farewell Priory in Staffordshire. St. Bartholomew's Church, there's a really complex one. Not your ordinary workaday St. Mary the Virgin fraud, mother of the gods in the universe. Fryston Priory, Lincolnshire. Great Brissett Priory, Suffolk. That's where the sheep come from, the Suffolk sheep, yeah? And the followers of all of these religious leaders just bleating, yeah, to be led innocently. It ain't gonna happen. Right then, Great Malvern Priory. I was gonna tell you about the Sutherland man who died that last week. Lord Peter Sutherland was being mourned in the Catholic Church. That is the people that run the RBS, yeah, that run NATO and run the UN after they're finished with RBS, okay, died last week. Okay, it's becoming a spate, and if all the ordinary people would just let the truth out about the people that govern them now, it would happen a lot quicker. Thank you to those that are listening to me and talking to me all of the time. Okay, the Great Malvern Priory, Worcestershire, Gresley Priory, Derbyshire again. Links to the Duke of Devon and what's the abbey where all the elites are on the telly all the time? Downton Abbey elites, run by the Duke of Devon from way up further north at the top of the Icknield Way. The Roman roads are at the heart of all of the frauds all across Europe still, and the names in the place names in the frauds in the new continents way out west where the YMCA is the joke, yet they're still the same place names. Hatfield Brook, Oak Priory, Essex again. Yeah, and the knaves are mentioned in HRH, the Queen's National Anthem. Yet they will get to the knavish tricks of our opponents abroad. It does not get sicker than this. And that song about vowing to your nation, yet your country, your allegiance, it is totally sicked. And all of it is treasonous. Which is why I've had to resort to showing you the pictures. Google will not let me post an image, a JPEG, or a file on my own website, and they pretend that they make space available for everyone on those massive websites and depositories for facts that they have, yet, which is, I forget what they call it, Google Plus or something, or Google Sites or Google, yet you can take all of your data and you can deposit it there, and you can send massive appendages to emails as long as they're allowed to read your secrets. It's as simple as that. Yeah, but they will not let me put one JPEG with a title that will allow it to be found on Google Images on my website, because my website is an icon for freedom now, and they fear that. Okay? Right then, Hatfield, the joke about the hatters and going in behind the wardrobe and into Alice in Wonderland's story, St. Andrew this time, the fraud, yeah, patron saint of 19 countries, did not exist either. Hexham Priory, yeah, where one of my children was christened. Okay? And right next door to where my children had to be taken to school in the morning and signed in and signed out, because in Liverpool, the crime scene, yeah, they had just murdered, allegedly, a man called Jamie Bolger. His murderer goes to the beating with me and works for the Duke of Northumberland and used to work as a chef in the Duke of Roxburgh's hotel. St. Andrew's Priory incorporates all sorts of posh little extensions. That's Hexham, Northumberland, where the Freemasons and the Rotary Club now will not talk to me because they fear all of my potency and my revelation that their capitalist icons are traitors to their own children, and their own children now have to pay £50,000 to go to university where they got to for free. That is capitalism, and that is fascism exemplified. Northumberland, Hexham. And Johnny Wilkinson's from just down the road in the epicentre of rugby fraud. And they have one of the legendary chefs in that town, yet where the bridge is crossed across the Tyne. And their name, the chefs were the... No, I can't remember it. Costs a fortune to wine and dine in elite Northumberland. Yeah, and when they retire, their pension funds are screwed. Yeah, as confirmed by the man who read the meter this morning. In one of the Ponzi shelves of the energy scamsters like John Major. Okay, Hainings Priory, Cistercian nuns, Naith, Lincolnshire. You remember in the Thomas Moore film that the man came from his closest friend, yeah, who became his enemy and was desperately keen just to get him to roll over and acknowledge that he must endorse what King Henry was trying to do to Christianity in England, yeah, otherwise he would be beheaded. The man refused to do it, and he came from the man who tried to persuade him to change his mind. He came from the flatlands, and many of the estates that are run by the Irish people are also run on the flatlands. And that is the scam that when Longshanks needs to get the Quislings in Scotland to turn around, he just gives them new lands. And in those days, when we went to war in the Holy Lands or all across Europe, it was the landowners who had to pay the taxes. Now they have freedom to kill the innocents who pay the taxes, and the landowners are on the corrupted boards, and now almost everything that they run is a virtual frauds company. Right then, I'm going wasting a lot of time on this, but I'm just going to name the place now. Okay, Naith, Lincolnshire, Abbey Town, Cumbria, Cistercian, Hurley, Berkshire, Benedictine, Trinitar, oh goodness, Home Cultram, Abbey Town, Cumbria, Hulry, Berkshire, Benedictine, Ingham, Norfolk, Trinitarian Canons, Jarrow, Tyne and Weir, yet it is Sunderland again, Benedictine, yet that's the Bede joke. It could be that Bede is the power base there. The names, they just twist the letters around, and all of a sudden you've got a myth who becomes a saint. And the man who was sainted at Eyemouth, or near Eyemouth, St. Abbs was sainted because she wanted to keep her virginity against these warlords. But the man St. Cuthbert was sainted because he saw two Otto years at the same time, and that's the Ottoman Emperor joke. Otto, Ottoman Emperor, Otto Onions, the onion seller from France, is in the cabal. It's a joke about the Roman Pisos and the Naples Pisos who launched the Christian fraud and wrote the Christian Bible. Kirkstead Abbey, Lincolnshire, Cistercian. South Kyme, Lincolnshire, Augustinian. Lancaster Priory, Lancaster, Lancashire. Yep, been there. Massive university. Frauds in the NHS too. Benedictine. Lanarkost, Cumbria, Augustinian. Yep, where blind Prince George sired the only legitimate child murdered by the illegitimate monarchy in the UK, who take us to war all of the time. And they pretend that they regret all of those decisions. Augustinian. The nave is used as the parish church of St. Mary Magdalene. Lapley Prior, Staffordshire. Very common at the dog show. Bull Terriers. Last Ingham Abbey, North Yorkshire. Lenton Priory, Nottingham, with the word ham in it, and Robin Hood, robbing Hood, as part of the joke. Leominster, Herefordshire, and that is also the place where the Able Danger people met, because the no notting joke is coming pouring out as they kill the children in world wars all over the place, all of the time, and they kill the pagans in their genocides, and they pretend to know nothing about it. Notting Hill, the massive financial frauds of Lord Hollick and Michael Grade in their cabals, east, west, and in the sporting and media sector. Leominster, Herefordshire. Leonard Stanley, Gloucestershire. Leatheringham, Suffolk. Little Dunmore, Essex. Little Malvern, Worcestershire. Malmesbury, Wiltshire. Old Malton, North Yorkshire. Marwick, North Yorkshire. Merivale, Warwickshire. Milton Abbas, Dorset. Abba joke. Abba, also a joke about the Piso family members when they were still in Italy before 140 AD. Minster Swale, Kent. Monks Kirby, Warwickshire. Yeah, where Warwick rules are applied to the inquests for the wars that are entirely for profit. That means that if you do not tell these lies that we have pre-prepared in writing for you as it was written, we will have you killed like the victims of the genocide in the war that we ran in that place. That's the University of Warwick rules. Yeah, and that's why Chilcot was still in the news earlier this week, because all of them are financial criminals on the interlocking boards, and none of them protect justice, they abuse it. Right then, Monk's Weir, Tyne and Weir, Benedictine again, the really big power base. That's where we sailed from for our honeymoon in what used to be pagan Norway. And we've given you the timeline for the conversion of the Norse to Christianity, so the kings, yeah, who they've still got kings there, can become the owners of the massive frauds, yeah, and the massive wealth, and their ordinary citizens get the blame. Okay, and we run all of their corrupted industries in the fish farming sector, and we're prepared, like Alex Salmond, to pollute our coastal regions using the corrupted pesticides that I used to work on as a CNS expert. Nuneaton Priory, Warwickshire. Benedictine. Nunmonkton, North Yorkshire. Benedictine. Owston and New Bolton, Leicestershire. Augustinian. Monkshire, Sherborne, Hampshire, with the word ham in it, right next door to to the triumvirates and Lord Mountbatten, who was topped for trying to muscle into Winston Churchill's triumvirate of Royal Associated Narcotics Launderers, Benedictine, Perthshire Worcestershire Benedictine, Pilton Devon Benedictine, Polesworth Warwickshire Benedictine. There's a Pilton in Hoyk, there's a Pilton in Edinburgh, and that is where the big drug running scene, made by the same actor, the Scotsman, that was in the Star Wars movies. Yeah, drug running by the royals. Yeah, and all of this fraud is just as massive. St. Mary the Virgin never lived, and she's all over the church names, all over our fraudulent country for 2,000 years. Polesworth, Warwickshire, Porchester, Hampshire. Lord Porchester, one of the Queen's sires, yeah, for her children. Isn't that a coincidence? Ramsey, Cambridgeshire, Benedictine, Reading, Berkshire, Franciscan friars. Yeah, St. Francis is alleged to be part of that Black Pope movement, yet that was the followers of the, they have a Black Pope and a White Pope, and they are launched out of Spain, and it is total fiction. They never actually existed, the saints that they were named after. Redlingfield Priory, Suffolk. Romsey Abbey, yeah, also in Hampshire. Beautiful, beautiful locations, lived in only by elites and by Pete Baines, who used to work with me as a doctor, a PhD doctor in science, but became a vicar because I went to work with him at Welcome, and they knew that over time I was born to expose this story. So Reverend Peter Baines, are you still alive? You should have a conscience now after all of what you've done and all of those collections that you've run for false Christianity. Church of St. Mary again. Royston Priory, Hertfordshire, yeah, where St. Albans Cathedral is. Yeah, and that's where the woman was picked to be the UN weapons inspector. Yeah, Baroness Amos. Yeah, she's got a totally decrepit IQ. She's got no O levels or hires or the English equivalent, and she is picked to be the leader and to try and find the assassinated President Morsi of the Islamic Brotherhood frauds. Yeah, where they try to brutalise every one of the participating countries. In Morsi's case, that's Egypt and the USAID issues. Rumborough, Suffolk, Benedictine. St. Albans, Hertfordshire, Benedictine. Thought so, one of the big ones. Yet we've been invited by the criminal Hancock's family to weddings there, but we were too poor to attend, even when my wife was prepared to live with me. Okay, St. Bees Priory, Cumbria, Benedictine. St. Germans Priory, Cornwall, Augustinian. St. Michael's Mount, Cornwall, Benedictine. Look at it, it's magnificent. The Arthurian one is just a wreck, because the Arthurian stories are just cover written by the popes about innocent democracies and kingdoms. We have none. Selby Abbey, North Yorkshire, Benedictine. Sempringham Abbey, Lincolnshire. Gilbert Tyne, never heard of that one yet, but the Gilbert Trust is the Jewish issue, yeah, run by the Rothschilds, and it's about stashing away in museums the art treasures from all of the formerly pagan countries all around our globe, and all of the victims of World War, run by the Rothschilds, who own the Gilbert Trust. Sherborne Abbey, Dorset, Benedictine. Shrewsbury Abbey, Shropshire, Benedictine. The big power base takes you back to George Clooney in France, right next to Avignon. And the Max guy that sings, yeah, for the comedians, Yeah, Max Byfield, Smithfield, St Bartholomew's Priory. Smithfield, is that right next door to where Jack the Ripper did the murders? In the royal family, Greater London. Yeah, and then fled to Glam's Castle. Yeah, and then they had to get another king in to replace him. Okay, Augustinian in this case, Southwark Priory, Greater London. Yeah, no postcode, Augustinian, magnificent. Stoggers Priory, Somerset, Benedictine, St Andrew's Church. Swine Priory, that's getting more descriptive. East Yorkshire, Cistercian nuns, oh. That could be a gender bias nomenclature issue. Yeah, that would be really serious in this day and age. Tewkesbury, Hampshire, Gloucestershire. Tewkesbury, Gloucestershire, Benedictine. Thorny Abbey, yeah, the joke about Jesus' crown. Cambridgeshire, immune from bombing in World War II. Benedictine, because they're really powerful. St Mary. Thurgarton Priory, Nottinghamshire, the land of the no-nottings and the free the world able danger concept. Quislings all, with the reverence to the preacher in the chat room. Augustinian, Tilty Abbey, Essex, Cistercian. Tutbury, yeah, Tutankhamun, the Egyptian gods, yeah. Tut is two letter T's, two Christian crosses, Benedictine, and the nave word that's in the national anthem is used again at Common as Muck, St Mary's the Virgin. Upholland Priory, Upholland, Benedictine, yeah. The Hollands are the Dutch monarchs who also launder the narcotics in the Philips light tubes. That's Prince Philip. Waltham Abbey, who lays the wreath at the cenotaph every year. Waltham Abbey, East Essex. Augustinian. Weybourne Priory, Norfolk, Flatlands again. Witham Charterhouse. Oh, we've got several charter houses around me. Nobody understands what they're about or what the charter was, and they tell me that it's nothing to do with tolling on the roads to let the people have the right to walk across the elite landowner's land. Yeah, but nobody's prepared to talk about it. Witham Friary, Somerset. Woodkirk. Oh, two jokes in one. Woodkirk. Yet the crucifix, West Yorkshire. St Mary's again, Augustinian. Workshop Priory, Nottingham, no Notting, Augustinian. Roxall Priory, Benedictine. Wimondham Abbey, with the word ham in it, Norfolk. Benedictine. Yet the man, I forget what his name is, Howard from Norfolk, the Duke of Norfolk, became King Henry's friend as he deserted the man who could already read and write in Latin. That is Thomas Moore. It's all a joke. All a joke. Yeah. And all of it. Goodness knows whether there was ever a Thomas Moore and whether he was ever executed. The saints are all made up. And all of them are shared with other countries because they haven't got the time or the imagination, because they're too busy filling their pockets to put integrity and reliable truth into these stories. York Holy Trinity Prior, Micklegate, Yorkshire, North Yorkshire, Benedictine, the powerful lot, the Priory lot, with the word Piso in the Priory's name. The writers and the defrauders of the Christian Bible. Right then, let's go to the Christianity timeline again, and I'm going to show you what happened out of the crime scene that is Free France. Yeah, they were in Buckinghamshire. Yeah,
completely safe from bombing through the whole of World War II. And I've got a monitor in my town who's a Rastafarian, who I used to play rugby against, and he's ever so decent now because he knows my insight and he knows my power. He might have the power to take me down, but he now fears the acts of God that will ensue. Right then. And he's a really nice chap, and I introduced him to my son and we talked to him. Okay, so it's not the timeline. We've done the timeline, yet right down to 1066 and Hastings and missing the kick and all of that stuff, and Hastings crashing the London companies in favour of the Bristol companies and just taking the cash. He's no longer to be seen on the rugby touchline. Thank you to Andrew Kerr for doing the decent thing for rugby and staying in the game. Yeah, and always talking to me when we meet. That's a Kerr with two R's, unlike the Duke of Roxburgh on the business registry and all of his wives. Right then, so this is the Cluny and St. Keys. So there's the crime scene that was Cluny Abbey, that had a pope for a time. Yeah, dedicated to St. Peter, yet non-existent, is former Benedictine monastery in Cluny. Saint-Oulard, it's on the Loire River. A river runs through it. It's got a Romanesque style, like all of the crimes. Cluny was founded by William the First, Duke of Aquitaine, in 910. Yeah. Okay. So this is how far down the timeline we are. He nominated Bernou. Now, I met a Bernie the other day, and he looked dead like that man Bernard Cribbins that used to laugh about the railway children, but he was really nice and he invited me to have a whiskey. Yeah, and I talked to them for a long time, and they're from Yorkshire and they have a genuine sense of humour, and they were able to laugh at the Ponzi scheme jokes about the cricketers there, who are Jeff Boycott, who runs Ponzi schemes with the aid of a man, and his companies are called Boyks. And then we talked about Michael Parkinson and his life cover Ponzi scams, and all of the Yorkshiremen were prepared to laugh. Yeah, and they took my website details away, and they're probably Freemasons, but they now respect me and they talk to me openly. Okay? Subject only to Pope Sergius III, the Abbey was notable for its strict... This is Cluny Abbey. Okay? And can you see it? In the Cluny Abbey name, it's pronounced Klein. Kleine. That's the launch of the Kleins. Yeah? That's Naomi Klein, the woman that I respected so much for exposing George W. Bush's crimes in Iraq, but then covering up the massive green scandals and pretending that she's a socialist on the Think Left sites. She's an elite profiteer too. And she gets several million pounds in advance to write the books about what the American presidents do in the name of homeland security all over the world. And that's land grabs all over the world. Here is the townhouse in Paris, known as the Hotel de Cluny. Yeah, the townhouses are all over the borders. Yeah, it is an icon. And the Duke of Roxburgh's registrations in the townhouse in Melrose are massive. Okay, in Paris they're known as the Hotel de Cluny, and the icon for the Abbots of Cluny way back in the 11th century, that's 1066, is the cross keys, like the cross keys on the hotel in the middle of my hometown, and the medieval square that we still have, and the Freemasons take 18 months to keep fixing the cobbled streets, because I'm back in town reporting every one of the Masonic crimes. And so far they have not had the courage to put me in a cornerstone of the building, which they used to do for centuries as a joke about the poor people and the victims of all of this. So, that's the saltire, yeah? Two gills, to be gulled, means to be cheated in Scotland. Saltire, the same as on the Scottish flag. I think that's in the last image on that list. Do you see it? The coat of arms of Cluny Abbey, the saltire. There's the Scottish flag and the icon for freedom. And you can see that the Christian cross is the icon on the sword that everybody uses to brutalise everybody else. Right then. So, let's get down and show you as much as we can before we have to close about the Cluny place. Yet that is the launch of the auld alliance between Scotland and Britain. It's not Scotland and France, it's Britain and France in the united Christianity fraud, which is now global, and you know all of that, and there are no pagans left anywhere. And William the Duke of Aquitaine just happened to be called the Pie-us, Count of Auvergne, mother house of the congregation of Cluny, and it's a commune, which is the communist thing that gets killed in en masse at the end of every great conflict because they pretend that they want to take the elite's money away. And all of the communist leaders are multi-millionaires on all of the land grabs that they have done on other people's continent. William placed Cluny under the protection of Saints Peter and Paul, who never exist, with a powerful curse on anyone who should violate the charter. With the Pope across the Alps in Italy, this meant the monastery was essentially independent, and it becomes filthy rich, and it's massive, just like the one that King Henry burnt down in Kelso. And they've got, all of them, the icon of the swastika, which is a Hebrew letter, in it. And when you look at Kelso's Abbey in an aerial map, you see the swastika. And the Dukes of Roxburgh with the people that look after them and do their administration, which are the only really big medal winners. Yeah, oh no, sorry. That's the factors. They're buried in the same place, and the factor's name is the same name that is causing all of the fuss and the job losses. That is the Storm of Darlings. Yeah, the Duke of Roxburgh's factor, one of the only victims in the leadership team, yeah, in the general ranks, to have been killed in warfare, and all of the other ranks are thousands and thousands in every war memorial that you go to. The papal schism of 1378 to 1409 further divided loyalties. France recognising a Pope at Avignon, yet where the Eric and Ernie music came from, and England won at Rome, interfered with the relations between Cluny and its dependent houses. Under the strain, some English houses, such as Lenton Priory, Nottingham, the no-nothing joke for the warmongers already into America, and that is the Putnam joke. Yeah, the no-nuttings are part of the Putnam. Do not run for your country on a Sunday joke, and they are the chariots of fire, genocidal people, and they pretend to be the Able Danger freedom movement, who do not understand that Christianity is a fraud, even although they cite the pastor in every episode that they make. Lenton, 1392, in Nottinghamshire. Lent, the word lent in it, to borrow money, and the Christian sacrifice joke. Do you get that one now? By the time of the French Revolution, the monks were so thoroughly identified with the ancien régime that the order was suppressed in France, and in 1790, the monastery at Cluny was almost totally demolished in 1810. Later, it was sold and used as a quarry until 1823. Today, little more than one of the original eight towers remains of the whole monastery. Yeah, there's nothing except the swastika left at the end. Yeah, the nave. Yeah, everybody has the jokes in their national anthem. The Yanks have the joke about the land of the Braves, who are the pagans, and the knaves are sung about as being the foreigners in the UK national anthem. The Abbey of Cluny differed in three ways from other Benedictine houses and confederations. Do you see it? why they were launching Sepp Blatter last week. It's the FIFA joke again, having the liturgy as its main form of work. So the CLUNY people are still working mainly with the pen, which is why they become so rich and so powerful, and that's why the Benedictines are the heads of most of the British subsidiaries. By the time it gets that far, CLUNY created a large federated order in which the administrators of subsidiary houses served as deputies of the abbot and CLUNY and answered to him, the CLUNYAC houses being directly under supervision of the abbot. The head of the order was styled as priories and not abbeys, so that's at the top of the pecking order because it's got the word Piso in it and it's got a strong implication of getting your priorities right. And suddenly when that becomes commonplace, they change it again and you have to build an abbey to cover them up, just like the Arians in the religious timelines that we've told you about, the counter movement, and just like the double agents in wartime. Okay, Benedictine monasteries, even of those of earlier formation, came to regard CLUNY as their guide when in 1016 Pope Benedict VIII decreed that the privileges of CLUNY be extended to subordinate houses, so they're the bosses. There was further incentive for Benedictine communities to join the CLUNYAC order. Yeah, none of this was in my head until the word CLUNY appeared in the Christian timeline, and that's only because they're bold enough to launch George CLUNY and the Coen brothers. And the Coen brothers are the high priests of Israel in the Jewish scams. That launches the kosher butchery, it launches the wives for the Rothschilds for many, many generations. And they'd launch bloodshed everywhere for women, so their presence was always limited. The order did not have an interest in founding many new houses for women, yeah? So the nuns were only mentioned in two or three in Britain, so their presence was always limited. Almost all of them are called St. Mary's after the virgin character that never lived. The customs of CLUNY represented a shift from the earlier ideal of a Benedictine monastery as an agriculturally self-sufficient unit. This was similar to the contemporary Aston Villa of the more Romanized parts of Europe and the manor of the more feudal parts, in which each member did physical labor as well as offering prayer. In 817, St. Benedict of Anian, yeah, Anian, we've just told you about, is the Ottoman link. Otto was the Piso family member who was linked to the Anian and the Anian sellers joke, and you've got it here. Change one letter and you've got the Anai Anici joke, who went to the Ottoman Empire to continue with things once they were forced out of Rome because they'd killed a couple of emperors already by the year 140 AD. Some of them went west into the Antonine Wall across Scotland, and all of those jokes that take you into Cramond. The second Benedict developed monastic constitutions at the urging of Louis the Pious, with the word pie in it, to govern all of the Carolingian, that's the lizard threat from outer space in David Icke's web pages, monasteries. He acknowledged that black monks, oh, you're not allowed to say that nowadays, yeah, is the louse perennius joke, that's Archie Louse, also one of the Piso family members way back.